What's the quickest way to count the number of subscribers on this list who are from Canada? It's by using Excel's COUNTIF function. The logic of this function is easy to understand. It counts cells based on a single criterion and has only two arguments: the range, that's where we want to search, and the criterion, that's what we want to search for. So we just type our equal sign, the function name, and open parenthesis to get started. Then the range we want Excel to search will be this column, G, from top to bottom, and after our comma comes the second and final argument, the criterion. What value are we searching for? It's the word Canada. We type that in double quotes. And notice that this isn't case sensitive. Whether we typed all uppercase, lowercase, or sentence case, Excel will just look for the letters and return the answer. We close our double quotes and close parenthesis and hit enter. And we just learned that we have 8 subscribers from Canada on this list. What about the number from the United States? Well, we could just repeat this process, or we could make it easier by pointing to a cell that has the value we're searching for. This is an especially good idea if we'll be performing several searches for several different values. We just type the criteria once and copy the formula. So we now know that these are the number of subscribers from Canada, and we want to find out how many are from the United States. Let's expand this column. And so we start out our formula the same way with the equal sign and function name, open parenthesis. Our range, of course, will be the same, column G, and a comma. But now our criteria will be the value that's in cell I5. Since the reference to I5 isn't a text string, we wouldn't type double quotes here. If we did, Excel would be searching for the actual letter I and the number 5, which obviously it wouldn't find in our range. So we click on this cell which has our value and close parenthesis. We hit enter, and there are 14 subscribers from the United States in our list. We can also search for a criterion that follows a logical pattern, like greater than, less than, or equal to. Let's search for how many members on this list have been subscribers for more than 5 years. We type equals, count if, open parenthesis. The range that we're searching for will start here at E4. By the way, we can press Ctrl, Shift, and down arrow all at the same time to select the values in this dataset all the way to the end. Mac users will press Command, Shift, down. And after our comma, the criterion will be double quotes, greater than 5, double quotes. Close parentheses and hit enter. We have 4 subscribers who've been with us for more than 5 years. We can also use the COUNTIF function in conjunction with wildcards to do partial searches, like this. We want to know how many subscribers are in New York, Texas, and Ontario. So let's just type these as our criteria here. We start by typing equals COUNTIF and open parenthesis. Our range will be the values starting with F4 and going all the way to the end of this dataset. We press Ctrl, Shift, and down arrow, or Command, Shift, down on a Mac. And it's a good idea to anchor the references to our cell range and make them absolute so that they don't get shifted when we copy our formula down. For that, we can press F4 on a PC or Command T on a Mac. After our range, we type a comma, and for this search, the name of the city doesn't matter. For example, we have one subscriber from Albany, New York, and another subscriber from New York, New York. Even though they're from different cities, we want them both counted because they're from the same state, New York. So we want to tell Excel that any number of characters can precede NY, but we want each occurrence to be counted. So in double quotes, because we're looking for text, we type an asterisk to represent any number of characters. Now we just close our double quotes here to move on to the remainder of our criteria, which is the ampersand sign to mean in conjunction with the value in cell I10. So Excel knows that it's looking for the value in cell I10 regardless of what character or characters appear before that value in the specified range. This could mean even no character at all. So if we deleted the city name, the state would still be counted. We close parenthesis and hit enter. We have 3 subscribers from New York, and let's copy for the other 2. 2 from Texas and 4 from Ontario. For more on how to use wildcard characters in Excel, check out our other videos and GoSkills resources. We can even make reference to another workbook with the COUNTIF function as long as that workbook is open. Pretty cool, right? Check out our other videos for more great productivity tools.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.